One of the most famous stars we can see, Betelgeuse, is set to go supernova extremely soon. And when it does, it will shine as bright as the full moon in our sky. And you will even be able to see it during the day. I guarantee you have seen Betelgeuse before. It is that extremely bright star with the red color that you can spot as the shoulder of the constellation Orion. Over the last few centuries, astronomers have been watching as Betelgeuse regularly brightens and dims in a strange manner. In 2019, we watched as it shot a huge amount of its surface out into space, creating a dust cloud that obscured our view of Betelgeuse. This variation in brightness happens every 400 days or so, and new research has just come out predicting Betelgeuse is in the end stages of its life, meaning it will go supernova much sooner than we thought. Now, the star itself is drastically different to our Sun. Located just 650 light years away from Earth, this star is a mere baby, on a cosmic scale, of course. Betelgeuse is just 10 million years old, and when you compare that to the 5 billion year age of our Sun, you start to understand just how young it really is. Now, despite being so young, Betelgeuse is nearly 1,000 times wider than our Sun. If we replaced the Sun with it, it would stretch all the way out to Jupiter. So if Betelgeuse is so young, why do we think it's already nearing the end of its life? Well, Betelgeuse has already run out of hydrogen fuel in its core. You see, stars actually work by fusing lighter elements like hydrogen and helium into the heavier elements inside of their cores. This converts a little bit of matter from those lighter elements into energy, producing the heat and light we get from stars. But there's only so much fuel a star can have. Our Sun has been working hard, fusing elements together for the last 5 billion years, and the hydrogen in its core won't run out for another 5 billion years or so. But Betelgeuse, on the other hand, was just born to be really massive. It is thought that Betelgeuse was once at least 10 times more massive than the Sun. These kinds of stars are really bright and hot, causing it to run out of hydrogen sooner. And at this point, the star expands into a red giant. And this is what we see with Betelgeuse now. It is currently a red giant, fusing carbon into the heavier elements, and the new research suggests that this carbon supply is getting smaller, and once it runs out, it will take just around 6 months to finally go supernova. In the autumn of 1604, the German astronomer Johannes Kepler gazed outside and noticed something strange. He spotted a star that wasn't there previously. This strange star appeared to be weirdly bright, far brighter than the other stars he could see. And so he did what all good astronomers do. He wrote down his observations in a book and published it. The book was named De Stella Nova, meaning about a new star in Latin. Kepler believed he watched a new star being born, when in reality, he had watched a star's explosive death. And that's where the name comes from, supernova. This supernova was 30 times more distant from Earth than Betelgeuse, so you can only imagine the kind of beauty we will see once Betelgeuse finally does go supernova. As a star comes to the end of its life and it's running out of fuel, a ball of iron begins to form in its heart. This iron ball is around 3,000 kilometers wide, at which point it weighs 1.4 times the mass of our Sun. And here's where something special happens. The protons in the iron absorb the electrons, forming neutrons, and this causes the core to collapse from 3,000 kilometers wide to just 30 kilometers wide in a few seconds. This leaves behind a neutron star and a stunning nebula of stellar debris. The new paper, which has caught everyone's eye, which I have linked down below, essentially looks at how Betelgeuse is brightening and dimming over time. They found four unique patterns that Betelgeuse appears to be going through. And remember earlier how I said stars are fusing elements together in their core, creating new elements? Well, this is actually what is causing these variations in brightness. The pressure of energy being released from a star is constantly fighting with gravity, causing the star to kind of pulsate. This is what we observe, and by modeling these pulsations, we can get an idea of what stage Betelgeuse is at in its life cycle. And it's these models that tell us that Betelgeuse is currently fusing carbon into heavier elements and no longer using hydrogen as fuel. If this is the case, Betelgeuse will go supernova in your lifetime, sometime in the next few decades. And I know that sounds like a long time still, but you need to remember that previous predictions had Betelgeuse going supernova in 10 to 100,000 years. So this is a really big jump. When Betelgeuse does finally go supernova, it will be brighter than an entire galaxy. To us on Earth, it will be as bright as a half moon. We will even be able to see it during the day. Over the following year or so, we would continue to see it brightly shining throughout the day, and it would take a few more years to finally fade away completely. Orion will sadly be missing its left shoulder. Animals here on Earth actually use the moon as navigation, something I'm actually covering in my next video that I'm filming right now over in New Zealand. But with Betelgeuse going supernova, we would expect some wildlife to be confused by the new bright light. Neutrinos from the supernova will reach Earth around a day in advance, so we will be able to get ready and watch as the supernova occurs in real time, seeing the death of our friend Betelgeuse. It would truly be one of the most special moments in all of human history. Us humans have actually been observing these phenomena for thousands of years now, and soon enough, it may be your turn. An event like this should occur once or twice every century throughout our galaxy, and more often than not, they don't occur close enough to us for a clear view. Nearly 1,000 years ago, on July 4th in the year 1054, Chinese astronomers famously documented seeing what they called a guest star. Native American petroglyphs also documented seeing this new star appear at the same time. The supernova was bright enough to be seen during the day for more than 20 days, and slowly dimmed away over the following 2 years. We now know that they were watching a supernova taking place. They were actually watching the formation of the very famous Crab Nebula. And I know what you're thinking. If Betelgeuse is just a few hundred light years away from us and it's about to go supernova, are we safe? Like, will the explosion hit Earth? Supernovae do pose a real threat to life here on Earth. During their explosions, they release cosmic rays that cause our atmosphere to lose part of its ozone layer, allowing more of this harmful radiation to reach the ground, causing issues for life here on Earth. Now, fortunately, Betelgeuse is far enough away to not cause any major issues. It may cause some damage to the ozone layer, resulting in a small increase in radiation for us here on Earth, but it's nothing to be worried about. For a supernova to cause us serious problems here on Earth, it would have to be within 150 light years. And this is actually what we think happened 2.6 million years ago. A mass extinction event that wiped out a third of all marine megafauna on Earth. Any supernova closer than 30 light years would cause major issues for us here on Earth, causing our ozone to reduce by half over hundreds or even thousands of years. This is capable of causing an extinction event. Now, fortunately, something like this is extremely rare, and it should only occur every billion years or so. For now though, we are safe. The closest Type 1a supernova candidate is IK Pegasi, a star 150 light years away. So don't lose sleep over supernovae. If anything, you should be excited because at least in theory, you will get to witness the explosion of Betelgeuse, something that is a truly once in a lifetime event.